Hello. This is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com, and today I'm here to talk to you about quantum jumping reality selection. More specifically, I'm here to talk about how you can tell when you're right alongside some parallel universes of possibility, and what the clues are, what it feels like. One of the ways that I'd like to talk about today has to do with sensing the future a little bit in advance. And I got to see an example of this in a Hollywood movie that just came out called Men in Black 3, starring Will Smith. And Will Smith encounters a character who is able to see a little bit into the future. And specifically, not just the future as if it's some set in stone thing, but no, rather a future of parallel universes that are all existing simultaneously, side by side, and it's even possible to determine what the probability is if one thing is happening that we're going down that decision path, that decision tree of reality selection into that particular parallel world of possibility. So what's really happening here is the idea with the many worlds theory that Hugh Everett III came up with originally in physics is that every time we come to a decision point, we are choosing our reality, choosing a universe. The same concept came up in another Hollywood movie a while back, starring Nicolas Cage. It's a movie I love. It's called Next. And Nicolas Cage plays a Las Vegas magician named Chris Johnson, and he goes on a journey. The tagline of the movie is, "If you can see the future, you can save it." He's able to see it just a little bit into the future, just enough so he can play with all these parallel worlds, all these possible realities. So, and I like the way that movie actually shows the way they might unfold and the way he can live through so many different realities. And it's just a fabulous, fun action film if you like that kind of thing. In my own life, I've sometimes experienced things a few seconds in advance, and most typically that would be sort of a warning sign of some sort, maybe a danger signal, if you will, that a car I'm about to get into might be in danger either where it is or where it's about to go. And this kind of full knowingness that I get, sometimes I'll get sort of a set of almost memories, and I think the term here would be future memory. And it could be accompanying something wonderful and fun or something that's a warning, either way. But when I get this kind of an experience, I'm getting a lot of participatory, I feel like I'm getting participation from my future self, who's guiding me to, come on, buy this shirt for a friend. You know this is going to be his favorite shirt if you buy it. And I get the memory that this is my friend's favorite shirt, even though I have to run through a lot of logic and reasoning and thinking, like what happened in the store that day when this occurred, to recognize this is a brand new shirt. It's this season's shirt. It's never been for sale anywhere before. Therefore, if I remember that my friend is wearing it and it's his favorite shirt, this must be a future memory I'm having right now. It's a little bit like deja vu, because sometimes I'll have a dream or a daydream, and that's a way of previewing a situation. So when I'm actually living it and I'm in it, I have a sense of how it may unfold, and also ways that I can maybe change things as the experience is unfolding real time. Another thing that can happen with all of this, is, besides the precognitive advanced viewing I discussed with Men in Black and the movie Next, and this whole thing of future memory, and sometimes getting some danger alerts, is that there's also a possibility when experiencing parallel worlds that you can, that a person can get into a little bit of a loop. And I write about this in my book Reality Shifts, when I once went to a meeting that was for a class, and there was an exchange of business cards happening. And the person to my right was just giving two of her business cards to the host of the event and also to me. And then the hostess walked away, and she came back just a little bit later and asked very pointedly for a business card from the person to my right. And the person to my right explained, she looked at me, we looked at each other, and she said, "I just gave you my card." And she'd done it very clearly. It wasn't the kind of thing a person could easily forget. So that's one of many times I've seen a loop in reality, where reality kind of repeats, like a little bit of an eddy current. And that's a little bit different than experiencing parallel universes, but I do think it's very related. And sometimes it seems like just the way that our consciousness moves through these universes can create a little bit of a cycling, circling effect, like a whirlpool in water. So that's just an excerpt from the book Reality Shifts. And until next time, I'm Cynthia Sue Larson with RealityShifters.com, inviting you to keep asking, how good can it get? Take care.